great tournament, a great tradition there. The NCAA's the final site is in Athens, Georgia, so you know we're playing it and hoping that our young guys get to experience those courts. They get to see the site. You know, the older guys, they played there, they played dual matches there. They know what to expect when we get to that final site. So these young guys, are, at least we give them an opportunity to have played on those courts before you get in that environment, which is obviously the goal. They're working really hard. I think we knew that they had good character coming in. You know, we'd spent enough time with all of them, but when you get them in a team environment, you never realize, you know, how exactly they're going to adapt, and, you know, what their true personality comes out. But so far, so good. They've been great. We've really had great chemistry on the team last year, and you know, having the majority of that team back and those guys just taking more ownership even from last year, so that's been impressive. Young guys are getting all the support they need in order to be successful. The returning guys, Brandon Ficky has really worked hard this summer. He did a lot of work on his own, and it shows. He's playing at a very high level. Jared Chaplin also put in a great deal of work, and that showed. You know, obviously, everybody, we've been reporting about how well Michaelis has done. You know, he's off playing Davis Cup right now for Latvia, which, I mean, it's just a great honor. And Michaelis, good luck. You know, it's a huge honor. So you know, we're all behind him. And lastly, Hunter. You know, people don't know this. It's probably a good time to share. Hunter Reese broke his wrist during the NCAAs. So he played the NCAA final site, as it turns out, with a broken wrist, and won in the round 16. Played both singles and doubles tournament with a broken wrist. And not that we think that's a good thing that he played with a broken wrist, but I think it shows you that Hunter Reese is hands down our program's best competitor. And if he can play, he will play. He gave everything he had for our program, and he's ready, healthy, out playing great, and he's ready to get better and help our program this year. He gives everything for Tennessee. The biggest challenge that our program faces is replacing John Collins, Taylor Patrick, Ed Jones. Those three guys were senior leaders of the highest level. They were in completely. They led the program emotionally. So you know, we lose that incredible intangible. So what we're relying on now is our current upperclassmen, our returners, to take on that, you know, that mantle of being the team leaders and, you know, the emotional leaders, and let these young guys just get used to being part of our program. You know, they have enough running around from going to class, understanding, you know, where they're living, how to get into their routine. So we need those upperclassmen to take on that mantle and let those young guys just grow and you know, follow their lead. So that's going to be the biggest obstacle, I think, for our success. In terms of the talent of the young guys, we have great talent. We've got great guys. We're very excited about them. The character of them seems to be wonderful, like I said. But we just need to let them just grow, you know, grow at their own pace, and our seniors will take the lead and help them through that process.